Friends, we've gathered here to praise God, and we're doing so, are we not? We're also here to witness to the faith that we have as we celebrate Dessie's life. We come together to share grief, to acknowledge the loss, and ask for God's grace that in any pain we have, we might find comfort, that in our sorrow, we might still find hope, and in death, we might look and feel the resurrection around us. I invite you to pray with me. Glorious God, how curious, and what a confession that we set aside this day and call it resurrection. We smile at the presumption and hope you smile too, but the truth is, holy friend, our words can't carry all the praise we want them to, or that they should, no matter how many trips we make. So this day, all is praise and thanks for all our days. We breathe, and it is your breath that fills us. We look, and it is your light by which we see. We move, and it is your energy moving in us. We listen, and even the stones speak of you. We touch, and you are between our finger and skin. We think, and the thoughts are but sparks from the fire of your truth. We love, and the throb is your presence. We laugh, and it is the rustle of your passing. We weep, and your spirit broods over us. We long, and it is the tug of your kingdom. O glorious God, for this curious day, for all the impulses that have brought us here, for the gifts that grace it, and for the gladness which accompanies it, for our lives, for those through whom we came to be, for friends through whom we see and hear greater worlds than otherwise we would, for all the doors of worship and music and praise through which we pass to larger worlds, and for the one who brought a kingdom to us, we pause to praise and thank you. With this one more trip of words, which leaves too much uncarried, but not unfelt, not unlived, not unloved. Thank you. I invite you to stand and we'll sing a favorite of Dessie's, How Great Thou Art, verses 1, 2, and 4. 1, 2, and 4. Warmed up now. I hung up my robe and stole about 5 years ago, so I'm a little rusty. I'm going to knock the rust off here. We have a special selection that the family is waiting to hear. And before we sing together, we'll listen to that.
Time
Let's pray together. Gracious God, we thank you for everything that has brought us to this moment. Most especially, we're grateful for our relationship with Dessie, for her big and sometimes bold and sassy life that makes us laugh and sing and smile. Be with us in this time. Amen. Now, please stand. Verses 1, 2, and 4.
Consider all the worlds thy hands have made.
The scripture lesson that has been selected by the family for today is from the book of Ecclesiastes in the Hebrew scriptures, chapter 11, verses 1 and then 7 to 9. I'll be reading from the Message. Be generous. Invest in acts of charity. Charity yields high returns. Oh, how sweet the light of day, and how wonderful to live in the sunshine. Even if you live a long time, don't take a single day for granted. Take delight in each light-filled hour, remembering that there will also be many dark days, and most of what comes your way is smoke. You who are young, make the most of your youth. Relish your youthful vigor. Follow the impulses of your heart. If something looks good to you, pursue it. But know also that not just anything goes. You have to answer to God for every last bit of it. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
I shared this song at my mother's funeral almost 10 years ago, and Ma said at the time, hey, I want that at mine too. And so, Ma, this is for you.
How desolate my life would be, how dark and drear my nights and days, if Jesus' face I did not see, to brighten all of judgment. Thank you.
It's good to be here to see friends and Dessie's friends and family and colleagues. David Yoon, I saw you slip in the back. Pastor Yoon. And Pastor Jason is on the board doing live streaming. His heart is as wide as a morning sunset, and that's why I'm here. Some churches would say, I don't know if I want the former pastor coming in here. And Jason said, Ed, you're a blessing. Come on down. I appreciate that. He didn't have to do that. Has anyone been to Mrs. Wilkes' family restaurant in Savannah? Raise your hand, look around. Mrs. Wilkes. Oh, my. So Gabrielle and I were in Savannah making our way to a wedding, I think, just a little south of there. And we said, we're going to stop in Savannah. It was not that long ago because I posted a picture of one of the buildings in the beautiful town of Savannah, and Carla says, what are you doing in Savannah? Ma's in Savannah. Here's her phone number. Call her. So I called Ma. And we were on the way to pick her up, and one of my other friends from Westfield said, what are you doing in Savannah? My friend owns a restaurant in Savannah. Just go there and tell him Rodney sent you. So we took Ma to this restaurant and said, Rodney sent us. That's how it started in Savannah. But there was the day when we made arrangements to go to Mrs. Wilkes. And Dessie had it under control. So if you've been to Mrs. Wilkes, have you stood in line? That line goes right around the corner, right? So we got in line. I guess it was lunchtime. I don't remember. And we're standing there. There's no Dessie. And we're standing there like, where's Dessie? She called on the cell phone. She said, where are you? I said, we're standing in line. She said, Dessie doesn't stand in line. There she was on the corner of West Jones and Whitaker by herself waiting for us to arrive. And she said, come with me. We walked down the block. We walked around the back of the restaurant, and we walked in the back door, and everybody said, Dessie! The cooks said, Dessie! Well, the wait staff, Dessie! She said, Dessie doesn't wait in line. That day was about an hour and a half, and before I forget, I'll tell you, the people that were right behind us when we left the building were waiting to come in at the front door. Dessie doesn't wait in line. We were enjoying some food, great food, fried chicken piled up high, hush puppies, you know the drill, right? Coleslaw. More food. You want more food? You want to eat more food? There was a guy there that was about very big. And he wasn't going to leave until he was ready to leave. I never saw one person eat so much. I think Mrs. Wilkes took a hit that day. But we were eating, and Dessie's looking around, and every waiter that came by, to my recollection, knew her, you know. If they didn't know her, they wanted to know her. And she said, oh, I used to live right across the street somewhere. I come in here all the time. I said, Dessie, that gentleman over by the wall, the guy with the white head of hair with a suit on, he looks like he's looking at everybody in here. Does he own the place? Oh, that's my friend. He does own the place. So we got up from the table after a good meal, and she said, come on, I want to introduce you to my friend. She goes up to her friend who was a member of the Methodist Church where they both went. She said, I want to introduce you to my pastor from New Jersey. He He looked at me without blinking. He said, "Are you an educated pastor?" I said, "Oh, this is a friend of Dessie's." Dessie said, "Of course he's educated." He said, "Where did you go to seminary?" I said, "Well, I went to Princeton Theological School. That's not a bad place." He said, "I don't think our pastor is educated at all." I didn't say anything because there's nothing but trouble after that. He said, "Well, it's mighty fine to meet an educated pastor." And we went over to the church together at some point in time and looked around. Dessie was awfully generous, wasn't she? She invested in acts of charity, usually quietly, in my experience. She loved living in the sunshine, even when it might have been dark outside. She looked for blessings, and that's what she saw most of the time. Did you ever notice that when you look for blessings, you see them? And when you don't see them. Dessie knew the difference. She had her dark days, we all do. But she knew that following the impulses in her heart was the way that she should go. And my experience is that she did that. A big part of her life, I learned recently, was her love of jazz and her helping to found the Cape May Jazz Festival. Or she was parts of it down in Cape May. If you haven't been, you better go. She loved supporting jazz music, and down in Savannah, she did the same. So we called the guys today. How about it? Thank you. My sense is that Dessie followed the impulses of her heart, and that's what made music happen. She loved music. I found that to be a great way to live. That's why Dessie and I got along so well. I don't know what she said to you, but I liked her a lot. I don't know what she said about me. Follow your heart. Isn't that a great way to live? The writer of Ecclesiastes, those words we just read, "Even if you live a long time, don't take a single day for granted." That day we visited, we ended up going to lunch. We ended up going back to her apartment. We ended up meeting all of her friends on the floor, and we left tired out. She tired us out that day. She delighted in each light-filled hour. That's my experience. I told him not to call me. We all know that there be plenty of dark days, and they come, and sometimes they last a long time, and sometimes they go. Sometimes they don't go. But if you don't look for the light, you won't see it. Toe-tapping, hand-clapping, life-grabbing, God-loving, friends-loving, that's Dessie. Sassy. With steadfast faith in Jesus, her Lord and Savior. She followed the impulses of her heart. Thanks be to God. There are some friends and family members that want to speak, and we have a microphone down here, or you can come up here, either one. And I don't know, you're going to start off, Carla? Carla's going to start it off.
Hello. I want to thank everyone for coming out today. It's to celebrate Mom. I don't really have too much to say because you all know Ma. She would be doing all the talking for me anyway. But her friend Onawumi wrote a little piece for her, and I'm going to read it. It's November 1992. Come with me to the evening session of the 10th anniversary of NABS, National Association of Black Storytellers Festival and Conference. It's my first time here. Beautiful black scholars and master storytellers whose panels and workshops has on the first day shed light on storytelling from black perspectives. Amazing. I take an aisle seat in the third row from the stage. A woman with sparkling eyes and a matching smile sits across the aisle. The storytelling concert starts. One storyteller in particular cracks her up. Her restrained laughter and dramatic body language cracks me up. We introduced ourselves. Glad to meet you, Dessie Baker. LOL. During what became a 30-year friendship, there were a number of times when I was called on to be a NAB storyteller pinch hitter. If there was room for Dessie to come along, well, that was icing on the proverbial cake. If, during other gatherings I've produced over the years, she determined the social climate needed a boost, she just raised her charm powers a notch. Her judgment was pretty much right on time. Her Josephine Baker-like coquette was known to show up if a good-looking man caught her eye. My. How she did that and remained a lady in good standing baffled me. Was she a perfect human being? No, which is why our friendship lasted, because neither am I. This is a good place to say, Dessie, I owe you an apology. I am pretty sure that I am not the only one who does. Anyway, I'll tell you why I owe you when we meet again. Until then, dear one, you remain a very smart, resilient, kind, generous, risk-taking, faith-walking memory with your mischievous, angelic self. Love you, Death. Onawumi. She just paints a beautiful picture of Ma. She was a friend like all of you out here. So we have some other friends that are going to speak. Stephen.
Keep it down back here. Hello, everyone. What I'm reading is on the back of your program. So I'll go ahead and read it. Let me put my glasses on so I can see. So Abarani was born in 1957 in Savannah, went to school, graduated, got his education, all that sort of stuff. He's known as a historian. He said his name came to him in a dream. So that's where it comes from. He's a historian, a columnist, a novelist, a poet, an artist. He's a co-author of an encyclopedia of the Harlem Renaissance. He's also accepted in 2007 as a member of the Academy of American Poets. He's author of The River of Winged Dreaming. He writes a lot about hip-hop, R&B, Martin Luther King Jr., presidential politics, international politics, and all sorts of things. So it's pretty well versed and has a lot of interesting things to say. This is called Where Only Freedom Reigned. It's prefaced by a quote by Anis Nin. Each friend represents a world in us, a world not born until they arrive. An elegy for Dessie Ellis Baker, 1931 to 2023. Friendship was our underground railroad. We traveled whichever direction we chose. One good laugh could set us on a flight beyond parallels of north or south or day or night, in tunnels of doubt and over bridges of trust. How could I have known I was entertaining angels unaware when you and Patricia listened while I shared? Poems with school children in the bookstore I managed, your kind approval felt like balm to a soul damaged. To rhythms of ancestral voices, your eyes danced like butterflies. How could I have known that single 1990s evening was the first step of a journey that would swirl into years? Such good talks about God, music, Harlem Renaissance heroes, and the empowering joy of liberating one's tears. Like merciful dawn, your spirit shined prayers bright and strong. Savannah's old story was a new chapter in your New Jersey life. For me, an attempt to make past wrongs right. If ever pain or regret had bound us in chains, friendship led us to lands where only freedom reigned. One moment feeling hunted, and the next so triumphant. Through torrents of uncertainty, your smile lit the way to see beyond the troubling waters of a storm-challenged day. There it is now, your smile, like a star sparkling declarations of life's sweeter moments and hope's timeless affirmations. Abrayani, May 2nd, 2023. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm going to ask you to say a short prayer with me because I didn't imagine it at all that I'd be tearful. I'm so overwhelmed. I want to thank you for the wonderful service. It was wonderful 5 minutes in. I want to thank all of you for being here to honor Aunt Dessie. I am no blood to the family. My name is Vanessa Edwards. I'm from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. I'm connected to Aunt Dessie because in the 50s, my grandparents moved to Harrisburg. Aunt Dessie was living there with Uncle Carl and Vicki. They were neighbors and became friends. And my grandmom and Aunt Dessie adopted each other. So Aunt Dessie was my aunt to me. And I needed to be here to share a few things that I thought it would just be uplifting. But I'm so touched. My tears are not of so much grief, but that poem was so powerful. And it says so much about who she is. So again, please pray with me as I share a few thoughts. When I was a kid, one of my favorite sentences to hear was, "We're going to Aunt Dessie's house." We only went once a year, and it was for a period of about 5 or 6 years from the time I was 5 till the time I was about 11. Aunt Dessie's warmth and hospitality was part of my introduction to the beach. Cape May Courthouse, what an odd name for a little place. In Wildwood, these were on our target once a year to get down. And my mother and father and my childhood, my grandparents, wonderful, wonderful people. But what Aunt Dessie poured in was very unique. Aunt Dessie, Uncle Carl, Vicki Kim, and Carla Jean, who was the first person I ever met who had two names. And Aunt Dessie always called her Carla Jean. Their cozy ranch home was full of laughter and fun. It was where I was introduced to charades. I remember so much Sly and the Family Stone during those years, and just a warmth there in the house. But I didn't think of it as their house. It was Aunt Dessie's house. Aunt Dessie was such a great captain. She was a cook in the kitchen, and I thought she was a great cook. And my mom and grandma were great cooks, but Aunt Dessie's, I only got it once a year, so it was kind of a big deal to have that opportunity. She introduced me to French toast, and I begged my mother, like, when are we gonna have French toast? Many years later, when I was an adult and took my children down when they were little, Aunt Dessie had a pork chop dinner for us. She was at home alone at that time. And there are a few meals in my life where I can tell you the whole menu, but we had pork chops and a salad with Italian dressing and corn on the cob, and it was just absolutely delicious. Aunt Dessie was like a problem solver, a superhero, and as has already been mentioned, kind of sassy. She taught me about how to deal with mosquitoes with that spray that was from Avon. It didn't say anything about mosquitoes. She said, if you want to keep it out of your house, just stick it in a hole in your screen and keep it from coming inside. She had stories that she shared with me about dealing with a snake in the backyard and a bat up in the attic. And these things, hearing them, were unique because a lot of women would say they'd get their husbands to deal with these things, but not Aunt Dessie. And at one point in time, I had a snake and a bat to deal with in the house. And of course, I was able to channel superhero. If Aunt Dessie can deal with a black snake, I can deal with a garter snake. She also had suggestions on how to take care of your sand that got inside your bathing suit, which was one of those itchy things that was problematic. You know, when I think about it, I just have to say that she poured in to the lives that were around her, and she poured into my life. I also had a chance to visit her in Savannah with just my husband, and she took the whole day, and she did exactly what the pastor shared about showing us things and just sharing her time. But the thing I think I will remember most is she basically just said, whatever you come in with, grab God's hand and deal with it. And I just want to thank my Aunt Dessie for that. My brother sends his love, and my mother sends her love. And I just want to thank my Aunt Dessie. God bless.
Good morning. My name is Rich Ferguson. I'm from Savannah. And to the pastor, family, musicians, and family and friends, what he said about Dessie, everybody called her Miss Dessie. I called her Dessie. We were friends for about 20 years, and we went to a lot of jazz concerts in Savannah, that annual festival, monthly jazz, and that's where I met her. You know, generally at functions, you know, she would be by herself, I'll be by myself, and they put us back in the corner. And then, you know, we formed a friendship. But she had a very good, close friend of hers, Ann Hartfield. We wind up, you know, becoming close friends. And she was sick, I was sick. You know, we all at some point in time is gonna have some problems. And she gave us, you know, comfort. But when Ann passed, Miss Dessie used to bring me food all the time. So at one point, you know, I told her, I said, Miss Dessie, you know, you don't have to bring me anything. Well, she said, Ann made me promise that I'll take care of you. And whew, it was hard when she told me that. But Pastor, there's some stories that you don't know about from Savannah.
I'm sure there are.
Yeah. Mrs. Wilkes is where President Obama ate when he came to Savannah. And the key was she knew the cooks back there. They were making the food. When you walked through them, she knew all of them, told them how to cook, what have you. So that was a part of what she knew. She would always take in the back. Miss Wilkes Lyons was always around the corner. One of the things that she always did, she was a good ambassador for the city. You know, if she wasn't such a good friend, you know, I wouldn't have came all the way up here to say this. And but she would always take you around. And I think when you were there, Carla, she had Johnny Brown, the the tour guide. She called him up. He was in the middle of a tour. And he came, and he just took him around. Miss Dessie, all her friends in Savannah, you know, send their condolences and they wish they were here. And, you know, it's nice for me to be here. Nice to see you all. And there's a lot more that I can say, but you both said, I can sit down now. All right, but it was nice and nice to listen to the band, the choir. You remind me of Savannah. I didn't think you would be talking about Savannah, but thank you for letting me share these few moments. Okay.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm sitting here listening and reading, and it looks like there's a common thread. And you'll see that as I read my little story about Miss Baker, that Dessie was a friend. She was a friend to a lot of people, especially me. My name is Marie Tate. And I was a friend of Dessie's for almost 40 years. And these are just a few of the memories that come to mind that I'd like to share with you. And to start off, there was a few Sundays ago, my pastor started her sermon by speaking about how we all like to feel special. And for some reason, I was just sitting there where we had a tornado hit our church recently, so we're back on Zoom. And I'm sitting there watching the service on a computer, and she talks about this feeling special, and Dessie just popped into my mind while she was preaching. And we all know that she was a special lady. I met Dessie while she and Carl were deeply involved in the Optimist organization. I came to rely on her while having a rough time at a convention and was able to cry on Dessie's shoulders. It was then that I knew we would be friends for life. I discovered throughout those years that Dessie was a friend to everyone she came in contact with. She always talked about her friends in Cape May Courthouse, but I didn't realize how she connected with people until visiting her in Savannah for about 30 days one year. I discovered that she had developed many, many friends since moving there. I don't remember names. I do remember Rich. I discovered that they all thought fondly of my friend. There was the artist, who she talked us into buying artwork from. There was the singer. There was the clothing store owner, the hairdresser, the Airbnb owner, the tour guide, the storyteller, and of course, Mrs. Wilkes, which has already been talked about. You couldn't go to Savannah and visit Dessie without a trip planned to Mrs. Wilkes to enjoy their fried chicken and sweet potato casserole. And she always told everybody at the table, because it was like family style, that you have to have the sweet potato casserole. It's to die for. One thing I learned about Dessie was if you gave her your phone number, you were guaranteed a call. One day, Dessie suggested that we get some tickets to the theater in New Brunswick, New Jersey. The experience lasted for about 5 years. Guess who became friends with the manager of the theater? Dessie. This led to shows at Radio City Music Hall and visit from these new friends in Savannah. One of my favorite memories of being with Dessie is going to New York during the Christmas season to see a Broadway play with her and her granddaughter, Dessie, to see a performance, of course, by a family friend. Dessie was one of those people whose light always shined and everyone was drawn to it. She was definitely a people person. I'm sure that her light is still shining in heaven as it was here on earth. In conclusion, I just wanted to read scripture, Matthew chapter 5, verse 16. Let your light shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. And I know that our Father has been seeing Dessie's good works, continuing to shine on all those around her. Thank you.
There will be time after we finish the service and go out to Callaway's together to share some more stories. And I know they'll flow just like good water in the spring. We're not done yet. We get to sing again. And one of Dessie's favorite hymns chosen for the service is number 714 in the hymn book. I think it's before you, but it's also on the screens. And we're going to be singing verses 1, 2, and 4. I know whom I have believed. Will you stand and we'll join together?
I know not my God's grandchildren.
When you pray, think of Dessie. And it'll put a lift in your step. If you're down, think of Dessie. You might come up a little bit. I remember when she first came, not long after Carla first showed up, and Dessie was a wee one. Carla wanted to sing in the choir. Dessie was little. I won't tell the whole story, Dessie. I said, Carla, come up in the choir. Just lay Dessie down in the front pew. And she led the way for people to fall asleep. I listened to my heart, and I can hear Dessie on the front pew right down, right where you are right now. She could snore, too. And Dessie, Miss Dessie, walked out of church and just on the way out said, you take care of my daughter, Carla. And we did. And she has become some of the glue that holds this place together. Thanks be to God. Well, it's time to pray again and to commend this woman that we love into God's care. Let's pray together. Gracious God, of all of us here gathered, your love never ends. When everything else in life fails, you are still God. And we pray to you for one another and the need that we have this day and for all anywhere who mourn with us this day. If there is doubt, shine light. When we become weak, be our strength. When we break apart, heal us back together. As we sorrow, grant us your peace that passes all of our other human understanding. Keep true in us the love which we hold for one another. And in all our ways, help us to trust you. And to you and your church on earth and in heaven, we offer our thanks now and forever. Oh God, all that you have given us is yours. And as first you gave Dessie to us, now it is time to give her back to you. Receive her, oh God, into your arms of mercy and meet a new friend. Raise Dessie up with all your people and receive us also and raise us into a new life. Help us so to love and serve you in this world that we too may enter into the joy of all that you've prepared for us in the world to come. Thanks be to God. Before we go out today, one more song that is a request. And we're going to sing it as a quartet up here, some of Dessie's friends, and we'll give it our best.
River.
want to thank the guys in the band that came today. Thank you very much. I want to thank the make-believe quartet. Make-believe we did that just right. And to Bob Colin for coming up and joining us today. I want to make sure to say a word to invite everyone to Callaway's. Callaway's, all you have to do, remember, is one thing. Go to the light and turn left. And it's on the left, up on Route 9. Okay? What are you going to do? Go to the and turn. There you have it. So maybe think of some great stories to share on your way. And it's a day to share them. And it's a day to make a promise to yourself and to the family that you'll share more stories in the weeks and months to come. Be in touch. This is no time to be by yourself. Now receive blessings from God. Deep peace, pure white of the moon to you. Deep peace, pure green of the grass to you. Deep peace, pure brown of the earth to you. Deep peace, pure gray of the morning dew to you. Deep peace, pure blue of the sky to you. Deep peace of the running waves to you. Deep peace of the flowing air to you. Deep peace of the quiet earth to you. Deep peace of the shining stars to you. Deep peace of the Son of Peace to you. Amen. Amen. Let us go out with joy. Thank you.